Well, thank you very much, Mr. Chairman. I just want to make a brief statement. It was a concern I had from an article in the National Journal last Friday, and it was that one of the colleagues on our committee was and the headline is, may actually block or put a hold on the confirmation of Chris Smith as Assistant Secretary of Energy for Fossil Fuel. It was rare in the sense that it was a member of the Democratic Party and is President Obama's nominee. So my colleague has concerns expressed today in this committee about Mr. Smith's role in approving liquefied natural gas exports. And I find this report in the National Journal about one of our colleagues' approaches as to be deeply troubling. It's difficult for me to understand how anyone could accuse the Obama administration of acting too fast on LNG exports. In nearly 3.5 years, the administration has used its discretion to approve only 5 applications to export liquefied natural gas. Meanwhile, the administration is sitting on over 20 pending applications. 10 of the applications have been pending for over a year. 3 of the applications have been pending for over 2 years. So it's not that the administration is acting too fast on liquefied natural gas exports. This administration is acting too slow. So I'm also troubled by the fact that my colleague, who is considering blocking Mr. Smith's confirmation, actually voted in favor on the Senate floor of the nuclear option, the option that blew up the Senate, changed the rules for how many votes are needed to confirm a nominee, voted ending the rights of all senators to delay the confirmation of a nominee until 60 senators vote to confirm the nominee. If the majority in the Senate decides to delay the confirmation of Mr. Smith, we will then know that the nuclear option had nothing to do with what they said on the Senate floor, which it had to, they say it had to do with the confirmation of President Obama's nominees. What we're going to know is that the nuclear option was intended basically to eliminate the rights of the minority party to delay the confirmation of nominees, but preserve the right of the majority party to do exactly the same thing. So the minority party doesn't have a right to delay confirmation of nominees until we get more questions answered, but the majority party preserves rights that they have now stripped from the minority. Last month, Mr. Smith received the full support of this committee, with one exception. If the majority party delays the confirmation of Mr. Smith, it will be an act of stunning hypocrisy, and it will constitute just another new low for the United States Senate. Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Thank you, Senator Barrasso. And as you and I have talked about before, you have my pledge to continue to work on this issue somehow in almost inimitable style. I've managed to get both camps a little bit unhappy because there are people who want unfettered exports or people who want none. And as I indicated, I still think that all of us, because of the kind of bipartisan approach we've shown, I think there's a sweet spot out there, not one dictated by government, but one that will be attractive in the marketplace. I want to make sure I'm on top of the numbers, but I think the administration has approved 4 so far. There are 2 more that are expected in upcoming, weeks. We work closely with them to try to articulate, at least for Washington talk, a marginally coherent approach, which would be case by case, looking at the cumulative effects. And then, as you and I have talked about in the West, we're very concerned about the regional aspects and why I felt strongly that Jordan Cove would at least get, a fair hearing, a chance to be able to express their views. So I think that's where it is with respect to the natural gas issue. And I just want you to know that I look forward to continuing to work with you on this issue. And I think that's why, and Senator Murkowski and I have talked about it, the question of oil exports is going to bring this whole issue of export policy front and center to the committee. And in a sense, and we've talked about this, this is a good problem to have. We didn't used to have this kind of issue. We weren't suddenly faced with, let's now have a discussion about exports, because we never had that kind of prospect. And of course, we've had this revolution in the Balkans and elsewhere. So I just want understood that we will continue to work closely with you.
No, I very much appreciate that, Mr. Chairman. You've been terrific in working on this, on trying to find a sweet spot and trying to find ways to improve our economy at home, as well as improve our ability to for overseas markets. The role of natural gas exports is huge, and just in terms of our foreign relationships with international security and impacting markets overseas. There's so much to be done with this, and you have been terrific on it. My concern is if the minority party has lost rights in this institution, not in this committee, on the institution, because I know people vote the way they want to vote, but when a member of the majority party says, I'm going to consider putting a hold on somebody until I get my way, and yet those same rights have been stripped from the minority party. And majorities and minorities switch around here, as they have over history. I think that is a very unfortunate situation, because if this is truly about getting the president's nominees in place quickly, then a member of the majority party should not have rights that members of the minority party do not have. So thank you, Mr. Chairman.
I